Joanne Ritchie has been making auto parts at Ford for 30 years, but now a new call to arms. She's helping Ford make desperately needed masks for healthcare workers.
We were laid off, and they asked me if I would be interested. And I'm like, why wouldn't I want to do this?
Giving back is in her DNA. In World War II, her grandmother made aircraft parts at Hudson Motors. And today, this is Joanne's daughter, Andrea, a nurse now on the front lines.
I see you're getting emotional there. Why?
Well, you know, she is putting herself out there like so many other people. And she has a little bit of my grandmother in her. She's bound, she's determined. Nothing's going to stop her.
Three Ritchie women, generations apart, are America strong.
GM is already making surgical masks in Michigan, and soon it will turn out ventilators in Indiana. The U.S. Department of Health and Human Services awarded a nearly $500 million contract to the automaker Wednesday to produce 30,000 ventilators for hospitals in short supply battling the coronavirus.
The plant ceased production, laying off workers like Don McMurray.
I don't think our country or this world prepared us for what we're going through now. So I think on all fronts, leadership has failed.
The company's stock price has plunged by nearly half, and Southeast Michigan became a coronavirus hotspot.
In just three short weeks, General Motors was able to transform its Kokomo plant's operations.
There's been this tremendous call to action and dedication of so many people to make this happen on the GM team, supported by the UAW, on the Ventec team, the supply base. It's truly been incredible, and I think it's just teams at their best.
Just next door from the General Motors plant is an unused office space now converted into a manufacturing facility to make these ventilators.
The United Auto Workers Local 292 group says nearly 200 General Motor employees were laid off due to the coronavirus, and dozens of others were indefinitely laid off because there wasn't enough work to be done at the plant. But now, a big opportunity awaits for people to help hospitals across the country. Employees say the job has some challenges, from working with auto parts to now producing a healthcare device. But many feel the job is worth having, as it's bringing back business to Kokomo.
President of the UAW Local 292 chapter says that General Motors will continue to make ventilators over the next year and a half here at this location.
UAW members from across the country have answered the call during the COVID-19 crisis. A membership founded on solidarity is proving that what is really essential is helping others at a time of desperate need.